In this video, I'll show you how to export an STL file from Shapr3D. I'll demonstrate the methods for exporting a single part or a complete assembly. This example model is one of my own designs, a desk-sized pegboard stand. It contains three bodies, the main plate and two identical feet. The first method I'll show you is exporting just one part. This is a handy option if you want to test print a component before committing to the entire assembly. To do this, hide all the bodies you don't want to include and leave only the one you do. In this case, one of the feet. Next, go to the top right and click Share, or use File on the left and choose Export. In the Export window, select STL as the file format for 3D printing. Make sure the option Save each first level item separately is toggled off, then click Export. Type in a name for the file, choose where you want it, and save it to your computer. When I open this file in my slicer, I'm using Bambu Studio, you'll see that only the foot has been exported, exactly as intended. Go to Open. Find the file you saved a moment ago and open it. This part is now ready to be printed by itself. All right, now let's move on to the second method. Switch back to Shapr3D and make all the bodies visible again. Once everything is showing, click Export. Select STL format. Just like before, make sure the option Save each first level item separately is turned off, and then click Export. Enter a name, then save the file to your computer. When I open this file in Bambu Studio, you'll notice it was exported as a single body, rather than three separate ones. This is not ideal, but it's an easy fix directly in Bambu Studio. Switch over to the object panel, it shows you one body only. Right-click on the body, and select Split, and then two objects. As you can see, the model is now separated into three distinct bodies. From here, you can rearrange them on the build plate, remove any parts you don't need, or even assign different colors and filaments. Even though this method works and gives you a usable file, I usually go with the next, and final, method instead. Now head back into Shapr3D, keep all bodies visible, and click Export again. This time, make sure Save each first level item separately is toggled on. Now click Export. The file you save will come as a zip folder. Enter a name, then save the file to your computer. After saving, navigate to its location, select it, and extract the contents. Inside the unzipped folder, you'll find two separate files, one for the pegboard plate and one for the foot. For me, this is the go-to method. Now, when you bring these files into Bambu Studio, you'll notice they import as separate objects right away, without you needing to do any extra work. A pop-up will appear asking if you'd like to load them as a single object with multiple parts. Choose No. I'll show you what happens when selecting this option first. The pegboard plate and the feet import as separate objects, which means you can move them around individually. The feet are combined here because two identical ones were visible in the model when exporting. If you only want to export a single foot, make sure to hide the duplicate before exporting. To split the 2 feet apart, just right-click on them, select Split, and then to Object. Now each foot is its own object. From here, you can arrange everything however you like on the build plate, or if you prefer, right-click on the build plate and use the Arrange function to have Bambu Studio auto-arrange them for you. Now, let's try importing the files again. But this time choose Yes on the pop-up. The plate and feet will come in as a grouped assembly, keeping their original positions. This is ideal for models that need to be printed in place, since all parts stay exactly where they belong. And that's it for exporting STL files from Shapr3D. If you want to share your designs, ask questions, or get more tips, join my Facebook group 3D Printing for Crafters. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you in the next tutorial.